it's a feeding video, but it's so important. Whenever you're breeding fish, especially if you're trying to breed fish for profit, before you can take those fish, you got those plecos, you want to take them to the store, you want to sell them online, you want to sell them at the auction, whatever you guys do, you have to get them to sellable size, and you have to get those adults to keep reproducing. So if you're not feeding them consistent and giving them large enough amounts, they're not going to do that for you. They're not going to grow. You're going to lose fish. The parents aren't going to spawn. They're not going to have as many babies when they do breed. So let's go through them and show you some of the plecos I have to a little bit of a fish room update at the same time. So let's go through these algae wafers. And as always, I always like to post any products and music in the description. So go ahead and check that out on my website down there too. But let's go ahead, let's look at some of the tanks. Let's see how the plecos are doing. Let's go ahead and do a little nighttime feeding.
So we're just gonna go tank by tank. I got the food lanes, I'm shuffling things around. But down here, I have some angelfish. We also have a lot of breeders that I'm keeping for sale and for future breeding. You can see I actually got this one big guy. I did a video on him.
You can see he's still doing well. That's a nice big male albino on the front left. You can see I've got tails and females, but I'm gonna give that two full algae wafers. I'll go through them at the end of the video and show them actually eating the food.
This tank here, I have a new pair of super reds and a grow out.
Things are getting scary.
Which I have some.
Oh no.
Almonds and albinos.
Had nowhere else to put those poor little tetras. But actually, it's giving my Oscar something to do. They normally fight with Oscar and beat him up, but this is giving him something to do. It's actually very entertaining to me too. Because he's got good short burst game, and he loves making them struggle. But he's not that fast. I have faster fish. That is harder to catch. That catfish right there is harder to catch. And then he lives with a pike.
Here you can see I have a nice long fin female and a common female. The males are hiding. There's a male. I'll break up some wafers in there. Also a dumpy sail tank, so I'm gonna have
Jack found the freeze-dried shrimp.
But these guys are just
wait, you think it's all normal to take one
up? I get the two wafers. Sorry, I'm shuffling things around. But these guys will all sink to the bottom. It's very important. If you ever get any of these wafers, you do not want them to float. It's good for livers, things like that. But if it floats, their plecos are not gonna feed on it, so they're not gonna get their food. See, there's my breeder male in this tank. There's a whole bunch of babies, so this is a very important tank. I need to feed it at least twice a day, and there'll be three wafers in there. Over here, I have another tank of kind of a group breeding. I'll give them about three wafers. Break them up, spread them out.
Watch out, Berger. Oh, he likes you? Show me how you're gonna do it. Like that. And then like that. Right? Good fish. Like that. And then like these.
Came from that tank I was talking about, how they first did genetics. There's one
monkfish super is. Really cool fish. It's one of my favorites. Long fin and a red. So that's very cool. And there's another fish I've just drawn out. Some commons, some normal reds. There's a few calicos back there. Here we have a random penny.
You're protective. You're already in protective mode. You're gonna get him. You're gonna get him.
Here I have a big stick of some long fins, albinos, and a super red male in here. Go get some wafers. I'm sorry I'm kind of jumping around, but I'm gonna go back with the kind of duplicator, but I think I'll get a better sight on these fish. But this tank, they're still breeding. I've got a lot of babies, two generations. So some real little guys. And the long fin back there. A lot of long fins. Some albinos are drawn too, which is really cool because there's no albino adults in this tank. But they'll get a few wafers. They're also breeding some purple deltas in here, the guppies. This tank here is a project of the spotted plecas, and a male is already taken to the king, which is really cool. Hopefully gets the breed going on. So these guys are just conditioning the breed. So if they can get an algae wave for me the other day, and they would grow up to mine, but they're not going to breed for me. Up here I have some guppies breeding. These are those purple deltas with some fine, but I have a long thin pair somewhere. And we'll probably find them later after they smell that wafer sitting there. Here we have just a handful of mixed commons and albinos. We're growing out. They are ready for sale. These guys will be on the website. But they'll get about halfway through the wafer every other feeding. So I'll vary the sizes. Down here is that tank I totally tripled the hiding places of. And the parents, this one we found that male. So these guys are just strictly growing out. So I'm going to give them two full wafers. And you can see there's just cover on that triple of plecus. So they can probably handle maybe three or four, but I don't want to over feed this tank and let that plug filter have to be more worth it than me. So you can see it's a little cloudy. Over here we have some more burrows and some water things in here. There's one on a piece of wood. Don't get a wafer, but break in half. These here's some real little babies. Some medium sized ones. There's a real little one. Okay, sorry guys. Got my camera flipped around. That's with my hand. I'm sorry about that. But there's like a common little focus. That's a long fin. Very young. Up here we have some super red fry, some baby plecas, go get a wafer. I'll split it in half, I'll put half on either side of the tank. And I'm also breeding these fancy guppies. They got some babies in here. Up here are some rams, about a month away from sale, and some water fins. So this tank will get a half wafer as well. And this tank, last but not least, definitely least my favorite tank of breeding. I have some super red breeds. This is my first time successfully growing out a pair and breeding. So they're going to get maybe 2 acres of this tank. Split it up. They're all over this tank. I have 2 generations of plecas in here. The parents are still in there breeding. So this is important. I'm feeding not only grow outs but also breeders. So you want to spread that thin out and make sure you get plenty of food. So hopefully I can see guys in growth. Hopefully I didn't miss any of the plecas tanks. I guess it's pretty good all in my paper. But let me go ahead, feed any tanks that I missed. But we're gonna go through and actually check those fish out. Late, so kind of grinding through making this video. I want to show you.
I started feeding there, I'm going to show you guys that. I want to kind of chime in and say, top three things I think are most important for breeding fish. First thing, obviously, you want to make sure you have adult fish to breed. So you need to have a male and female. They have to be healthy. Make sure their stomachs aren't sunken in. They don't have any fungus on their fins, anything like that. If your fish are healthy, you're good to go. That's step one. Number two, more important than food, is good water. So you need to have a nice water change schedule where your nitrates stay low. You have a nice cycle aquarium. That's very important. And you want to make sure you do those frequent water changes. Not every day, which you can do, but maybe once a week. You're going to go through, do at least a 50% water change. And you're not going to go home and do it, oh, he said 50%, I'm going to do it today. And it's been a month since your last change. You want to gradually get them conditioned to a water change schedule. So say you're every 3 weeks, go to every 2 weeks, every week and a half, every 10 days, once a week, maybe every 4 days for a while until they trigger a spawn, until they breed. You want to gradually get your nitrates lower and lower, or you want to space it out every day. You don't want to jump to 2 weeks. You want to go maybe 3 days, 6 days, a week, 10 days, things like that. You want to condition your fish, make sure the water stays clean. And then, like I said, this is the most important thing, is food. That's going to determine, once you have the fish, once they're healthy, once you're on a good water change schedule, and you're doing a good job for them. You need to feed them consistent, large amounts, where they can always have food available, they're fat, they're healthy, and then they can actually have the energy to breed and produce eggs, and then the babies can also feed on any food in the tank also. So once you're feeding the parents and they breed, now you can slowly ramp up that food schedule to make sure that they keep breeding and keep growing. And you can keep doing that and eventually have those fish big enough to sell and grow out more fish that you breed in the future that will be even nicer colors. It'll be more conditioned to your water, your pH. Say you're breeding rams, and your pH is at 8, and it's super high, and you want it to be at 7. Or, they're coming from 7, yours is 8, and you want to keep them at 8. So get those breeders ready to go, have them finally live and breed in your higher pH, and then their babies, keep them at that 8.0 pH, and you want to breed them, and that's all they're going to know. You're going to have a line-bred fish that now you're almost cheating their background. They're not used to living in the rivers where they have a 5 or a 6 pH. Now they're used to 8, and it's your own domesticated strain of fish.
Oh my god!
That's fascinating breeding any animal and fish, particularly. You can change any fish to be your own. So it's very cool. It's very cool for selling. You can have more people enjoy a certain type of fish in the hobby that they can't regularly keep. So you can kind of be that guy that every discus is really hard water, or I don't use RO water, and they thrive and they're great. You can breed that, you can line breed it, where those fish are stronger and they're used to that, and then more people that have your same water are going to have great success. So a little jumping in there, throwing some more advice out there for breeding for profit. But let's go ahead and look at the fun stuff. Let's see some of these buckets feeding on their wings.
So hopefully I don't scare them when I'm talking in close. I got a little swarm of plecos in here. So over here you can see all the babies feeding on that wafer. That one else is moving around. I got that female, that super red. She's feeding over there as well. We got her boyfriend checking around. He might come out of the gate and feed. He's also going to try to draw her in there to breed soon. And she'll be ready to breed because she'll be healthy and fat. So that's really good. We'll go down to the adult tank.
If you could only see the way she loves me, maybe you would understand.
Tank. He's kind of cool. But we've got a plecko back there. Fortunately, we just